All right, everyone. Welcome to Star Wars Rogue Squadron.
Take an early morning run over Mos Eisley with Wedge Antilles, but keep your eyes open for any suspicious activity.
Even though we're just gonna... Since we're Rogue Squadron, we'll go with Cannon and actually pilot the next one. Nice.
My name is Mr.
Wilson, and I'm here to say. Quick question, Aaron. You're a Star Wars fan. Does every single Star Wars game have this intro?
Star Wars.
Are you dabbed in it?
What?
Does every game have this?
I don't have anything.
You know where it has, like, the beginning of, like, the movie? Where's the Star Wars is a scrolling thing? Does every game have that?
I think so, honestly. Does The Force Unleashed?
I don't remember.
I think it does. In the very beginning. You have to. You can't make a Star Wars game and not have the fucking intro.
Dun, 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 dun.
Down. I want to rewatch them, but I never feel like that's a fucking commitment, dude.
That, yeah, from watching the first all the way to the six. Ooh.
I probably watched some new ones as well. Why not?
What about the prequels?
Yeah. 1 through 8.
No, like the prequels of the sequels.
Good morning, Wedge.
The what? Squadron
like Solo and Would you include nah?
Solo wasn't that good in my opinion.
Meh.
I feel like Rogue One got a lot of, like, love for a really... I don't know. Rogue One, everyone's like, it's the best of the new ones. And it wasn't bad, but it's like... It only... To me, Rogue One got good at the end. But it's like you watch, like, a 2-hour movie for the fucking fight at the end. That's like Episode 2. It's the exact same thing. Episode 2, nothing happens until the end.
Fuck.
That's how I feel like Rogue One is.
And there are
I feel like nothing happens until the end.
Which
but if I did rewatch them, I think I'd skip episode 2, honestly. Or I would just skip around to the funny quotes that I remember.
And then just take the DVD out to put in the next one. Yep.
I like episode 3.
Episode 3
is really good. I don't get why I feel like it's pretty hated. I guess it's because there's so much talking. It's like, it's a really long movie with a lot of talking, but it has like the coolest fights, you know?
I agree.
It's so sick.
So now you guys can really feel like you're in an X-Wing, so this game revolutionized.
What are some quotes from episode 2? Exactly.
If you didn't ask me that question, I probably could have thought of some, but...
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, Matt.
Oh,
the only
shit.
Quote I can think of off the top of my head is in the very beginning when the spy or whatever puts those like worm things in Padme's room and Obi-Wan's like, I sent the dude, let's go. Wherever that goes. Anakin's like, do you sense that? Let's go. Or the cool part in 2 is the fucking big fight and then the thing with Count Dooku.
Where Yoda's doing the jumping around.
Oh,
so.
That's a quote. The fucking, there's no bounty hunters here.
We saved Mos Eisley. Do you remember that, Gavin? When Mos Eisley was getting bombed by TIE fighters?
Oh yeah. In episode 10.
Yeah. I don't remember if this game was considered canon or not.
Well, it doesn't matter anymore, because I don't think it would be anymore.
Yeah.
Because I thought that, dangerous imperial territory over the humid lands of now the only things considered canon are the movies and then, like, the occasional side things that have come out recently.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, apparently that game is considered canon.
What game?
Jedi Fallen Order. That's coming out.
That takes place, like, after, like, what, a year after Order 66, or...?
I don't remember. It's, yeah, something like that. Dude, the weird thing is, that guy, I don't remember his name, but he's, like, super powerful. I wonder what his story's gonna be. Because, did you watch the gameplay?
Yeah, I watched the gameplay.
Dude, he froze bullets.
Yeah, froze blaster shots.
I always say bullets, but, like, I don't know what else to call them. Blaster shots? But that's, like, so crazy to me because isn't the only other person to do that Kylo Ren? I don't think anyone else
has ever done, like, or at least in the movies, no, we haven't seen, like, anyone do that.
Yeah, so that's crazy. I would assume that BT's, like, really powerful. Because that seems like such a, like, rare thing that people can do.
Fuck.
One thing I don't like about that game being canon, though, and this is just me being picky, is, like, all these powers he has, but, like, no one ever does it in the movies. Like, he can, like, freeze an object, and, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, they show that, like, fan going by, and he stops it and walks through, and it's like, that's cool for a game, but, like, the picky me is like, well, no one's ever fucking done that. But, I don't know, I think that game might be cool. It literally looks exactly like Sekiro, so... And I love Sekiro.
Let me hurry up and get back over there. Speedrunning tactics.
I don't think I'll get it on release, but... I want it.
And Fallen Order does look good. I feel like it'd be a good successor to,
Force Unleashed?
Yeah. We got TIE Bombers coming up. There's actually a lot of speedrun of this game, and from what I've read, a lot of speedrunners hate this level because you gotta follow the transports. Don't think another set of fighters show up for a minute, so let me go ahead.
Oh, I know why it's so hot in my room. The vent's not open.
That will do it. I could be really wrong, but I do believe that the guy who played Wedge in the movie also did his voice in the game. I could be mistaken, though. But I believe he did. Yeah, you can hold the up C button, look around your cockpit. I probably should show off the other ships because there's like not that many missions with like, well actually there's no missions with the Naboo Starfighter. That'd be kind of cool to show off. I think the TIE Fighters come this way. I know it's gonna be a minute. Be gone with him! Dude, such serious music. I will say I've never been disappointed in the music in any Star Wars game. I'm purposely missing, just let you guys know. Yep. Moving on ahead. I think there's just two turrets here. Yep. Let's see. there's like a bonus area over here, like a tower, a blaster tower.
Commander, this is Riken. It's imperative you stay with the supply vehicle.
Yeah, he gets super pissed at you if you leave.
Commander, this is Riken. It's imperative you stay with the supply vehicle.
They're fine. Like, one more set of fighters show up. Or bombers, I mean. Speed of the devil. I hear shooting. There they are. And down. I will say, man, like, Nintendo 64 came out with a lot of good games. Nintendo knew what they were doing. Come on, hurry up! There we go.
Nintendo's good, pretty good.
Pretty good.
The shuttle is clear. She'll pick up the rest of this cargo. The Rebel Alliance will appreciate those supplies, especially after we lost Yavin.
Okay, I couldn't remember. This does take place after the Death Star. This is like what Luke was doing in between the first, the fourth movie and the fifth movie. Allegedly.
Race against time to recover the crew and cargo of a downed Rebel ship before the Imperials beat you to it.
I hope you guys are ready for some A-Wing action.
Rogue Squadron, this is General Riken. The Rebel ship.
And my cats are beating the shit out of each other.
Somewhere in this vicinity. It was carrying a team of Rebel soldiers and stolen Imperial equipment. You must find them before the Imperials do.
So I'm probably gonna crash a shit ton of times here. Or my shield's gonna get wrecked. Because they just give you a shit ton of ties, like, right in the beginning. Ooh, oh! I didn't get hit.
We have to keep searching for the Nona. Right with you, boss. Stay low. Ouch, shields are a little weak.
Rear shield's down!
Nope, one's down. Alright, not here. Ah! This is when they start targeting you. I think there's three areas in the map where it could be. Back that way where it just was, and a lot of times it's here. Oh, no, it's not here. Oh, this is interesting. Okay. So it's the other way. Interesting. I tried to shoot it, but it didn't work.
Starts on June 20. Oh, that's tomorrow. June 23rd.
What time? There it is.
11:30 a.m. something. I'm on the Twitch app, so it's cut off. It's either PT or ET. I don't know. Probably PST, considering I think it's on the West Coast this time. Dude, I really want that Bloodstained Ritual of the Night. That game looks so sick. I wonder how much it is. Looks like it's like Castlevania, Castlevania Night, made by the same person, I believe. That's probably why. Or that is why it looks so similar. Fuck, it looks so good. Have you seen that game, Matt?
I haven't seen gameplay of that yet.
Oh, it looks so fucking good. It looks exactly like Castlevania Symphony of the Night. Because there was that other one that we have on Xbox. Or no, maybe I had it through Game Pass. I don't remember if it was like free or what. But there's the other Bloodstained that was like, it plays like old school Castlevania. And then they made a new one that plays like Symphony of the Night, which is more like Dead Cells, if you will. Or where Dead Cells got the inspiration. But fuck, I'm gonna play it. It looks so good! I'm gonna look at how much it is.
Get out of here, ATPTs. We don't want you here. Fuck more bombers. Or you could just knock your ship right into them, that'll work. Big shot like big. I almost knocked my ship into him again too. Hurry up and rescue them! I'll shoot that ship, the ship that can't be destroyed. Any bombers? Yes, there are. What's up, bombers? You can fly a TIE fighter in this game. It'd be kind of cool to fly a bomber, too. Escort mission. I think this is like the only game that I could think of that that has like back-to-back escort missions. I got shot down. And Luke's dead. Catch up with the bombers don't bother nobody. Yeah, they just keep consistently spawning fighters. And we're gonna get a mission complete any second. And mission complete. Nice.
The shuttle is away. Rogue leader, get your squadron out of there.
Ba-da-da-da.
Imperial officer Fritz Nadine wishes to join the Rebel Alliance. The Empire will do anything.
$40 God damn.
Nadine makes good his escape.
$40
$40, little man. Put that shit in my hand. Hope you guys like snow speeders.
I want this fucking game, so gimme, gimme, gimme. Donate to me. Gimme money. I wanna get bloodstained.
And since we have snow speeders, you guys know what that means.
This is Luke Skywalker, go ahead. I've received word an Imperial officer, Christian Maydean, wants to defect. Apparently he has a lot of information on the Empire's military ground operation. I'm going to contact him after my meeting with the city officials in the Capitol Tower. Keep your eyes open for any sign of trouble.
Doesn't Corellia sound familiar to you, Gavin?
Form up!
No? Doesn't sound familiar?
I copy. Increase speed, full throttle.
Right with you, boss.
Maintain visual scanning.
Don't worry, you will know. We're gonna have a guest appearance in the game. More freaking probe droids. And then head back.
Repeat, under attack. Get back here as soon as you can. Rogue group, we are under.
You heard him. Full throttle back to the city.
Just love that noise. Alright, let's fucking save Corellia. The city, Corellia.
That's not real.
It is real. A certain someone in a movie that you've seen lives here.
It's not in the Jedi Archives. It does not exist. Hey, that's an episode 2 quote.
Oh my god, I almost rammed fucking face first into the building.
I don't remember that quote.
More bombers. Gotcha, bruh. Oh, really? Just a small difference in the snow speeder.
That's the tech center. Chris Nadine is inside.
More bombers headed this way.
Alright, gotta head back this way now. A lot of flying back and forth.
Got a problem here. Inbound fighter to F-13. Hold on, Wedge.
Yee-haw! It's the Millennium Falcon.
Well, what are you doing here?
How you doing, kid? Thought I might give you a hand. This is my hometown, after all.
There's like little speeders. Those are like optional to blow up, but...
Approach to the Capitol Tower.
There we go. That's why we have snow speeders.
Use your harpoons and tow cables. Go for the legs. Activate harpoon.
You hold the Z button while you're doing this, you make sharper turns.
Last time I saw my ass,
you're still me
out. Still
chocolate, man.
Cable out, let her go.
Hey, we took out the camel.
I've got trouble over here. They just dropped a pair of scout walkers outside my building.
Oh, now we gotta fly all the way back. Don't really have to worry too much about the bombers and stuff since Han and Chewie are here.
Man.
God. Oh fuck, I forgot there was a walker too. Shit. Let's take care of the AT-STs first.
A walker?
Walker.
Texas?
Ranger. Yeah, you can kill stormtroopers and all you hear is ah before they burst into flames.
You gotta do the Wilhelm scream.
They do.
I'm saying you gotta do it.
Ah!
That was the one close to.
One more pass.
Come on, Dak.
Cable out. Let her go.
Hey.
We're dispatching a shuttle to evacuate Maydeen. Keep those ties off its back.
I'ma try.
That's like little miniature versions of that.
You don't really have to worry about those stormtroopers on the ground. They don't really do nothing. Hey, look, there's the Falcon.
Dewey says we should start evacuating the people off the top of the Capitol Tower.
Dude, listen to what Chewie says. He knows what he's talking about.
And that is a motherfucking fact.
That is a fact that Chewie does know what he's talking about. Blow these up.
We've just lost contact with the shuttle.
Oh, what?
Rogue Squadron mission is a failure. Abort mission.
Nani?
Nani.
Wow. How'd the shuttle get destroyed?
Damn, bro.
Damn, how'd the shuttle blow up? Fuck, now I gotta start over. God damn it.
No, that's canon now.
It's canon now. Trix Maydeen never fucking makes it to the fucking meeting in episode 4.
Picking up something strange on my scope. I copy. Increase speed, full throttle. Right with you, boss. Maintain visual scanning.
That's weird, because I took out all the TIE fighters. I mean, the bombers. But then again, it's been like 20 years since I played this. Because I was going to play Final Fantasy X today, but we have a upcoming big fight, and I've got kind of need to grind a little bit. So, I'll probably spend... Oh, shit! Thank God these things hover the ground. I'm looking at the fucking computer, and I'm like, all I see is me going into the ground.
They're attacking the city.
Rogue group, those bombers are heading straight for us. There are lots of innocent people in here.
No shit, Sherlock. And plus, you know, no offense, sir, but you know, I'm not the only person here. There's two other guys with me. That could have protected that shuttle.
Free real estate.
Free real estate. I'm about to say, where the fuck is the other bomber? Get out of here. Alright, let me fly back to Riken, because he's going to say something. Or maybe not. Oh, okay. I was about to say, is there more bombers? Oh, no. One more bomber.
Right. Can you hear me? Rogue Squadron, this is Crix Maydeen. The attack came before I could reach Riken, and I'm pinned down in the tech center. Can you get me out?
Affirmative.
I will say, if you're playing this for the first time, I think first-time players are going to have, like, probably the hardest time with the Snowspeeder missions. I would consider them a little bit harder.
Rogue
That's the tech center. Chris Nadine is inside.
More bombers headed this way.
Is Mario Maker 2 out?
No.
Sorry. Got a problem here. Inbound fighter to 1013. Hold on, Wedge.
Tom intended to release it early.
Alright. Beep boop boop beep boop boop.
How you doing, kid? Ring, thought I might give you a hand. This is ring, my hometown after
come,
all.
Come along with Dave Bowser.
Dave Bowser's office. Yes. Hi. This is Matt, the funny man here. I mean, if you don't know me, I'm that guy that does jokes on the internet. Oh, okay. Yeah, we're gonna need you to release Mario Maker 2 a little bit early for my buddy Gavin. He's really, really interested in playing your game. All right, I'll trip one out right now. Thank you, sir. Have a good day. Thank you.
Wait, Gavin? Gavin GL?
Joey says we should start evacuating the people off the top of the
camp. On the way, ASAP. Tell him to check his email. Why did we make Dave Bowser sound like a gun?
I wonder if his name truly is like his last name is Bowser.
That is his name. What?
I want to see his driver's license. Oh fuck, I almost fucked this up. Oh, I can't see. Okay, we're good.
Rhodes, I've got trouble over here.
Tell me, do you think that they would lie to us?
No. I would hope not. And yes, those stormtroopers can absolutely damage your ship. That much damage, but oh fuck, Walker's leg smacked me in the face. Yes,
one more pass. Cable out, let her go.
Commander Skywalker, we're dispatching a shuttle to evacuate Maydeen. Keep those ties off its back.
Okay, here's the shuttle. I just went the wrong way, that's all. Make sure there's nothing that's gonna affect Crick's Median shuttle. No. Alright, cool. So we'll head over to the other area because I know there's probably more bombers over there. Yeah, take that, stormtrooper. Oh wait, no, those still speeders? Yes, they are. Okay, they're good. I'll go by Crick's Maydeen then. Just in case fucking fighters want to show up out of nowhere and just start shooting, and I'm nowhere near them.
Thanks, Rogue Group. I'm clear.
Yeah, we did it.
We'll be right back.
Oh, good.
General Reagan!
It's all right, Luke. You held them off long enough. We evacuated everyone just in time. Thanks to Captain Solo and Chewbacca. Nah, that was never my favorite building anyway.
The cowardly Imperial governor is looting the city, using his luxury yachts to transport stolen goods. Help the citizens of Gerard V keep their rightful treasures and stop the Empire in its tracks.
Alright, so I'm gonna show off a bonus vehicle that you can unlock, which would be...
Fuck!
The Naboo Starfighter.
Gerard V is attempting to gain its independence, but the Imperial Governor is looting the city. Rogue Squadron, you must protect Crix Maydeen's Y-Wings while they disable the escaping ship.
Don't worry, we're not so helpless.
Plus, there's missile turrets in this level, and I feel like the Naboo Starfighter is a little bit better.
Accelerate to attack speed. I'm hit, but not bad.
Oh, I'm locked on.
Good work. I'm hit.
One down. Let's keep up the good work.
Red, shield down.
Oh, there's another one. Get out of here. Thanks.
I'm clear.
I think I see some ATPTs. Yes, I do. Alright, cool. Oh! I almost smack dab right into the ground. Alright, so we can kind of... I was about to say, I know there's another one around here. There we go. Now they're good. And take this opportunity to take out some more of those turrets. Because they're already clear, so I can just... Oh, okay, maybe not. Who's attacking you guys? Oh, well, never mind.
Cut the chatter.
Oh, jeez, you wouldn't make me fucking run into a building cutscene.
We're gonna have company real soon.
I hear an ATPT. It doesn't matter, they're already moving on to the next area anyway.
Going ham on Tetris for this
stupid event. God damn. Yo.
Nice shot.
Thanks. Naboo Starfighter is a pretty good ship. And you can use it for like any mission where an X-Wing is used. Let's look for some TIEs.
Rogue Squadron, where's our cover?
I'm trying, man.
You're freaking. Freaking flippers.
Yeah, because I took out all the gun placements. Just the TIEs are kind of hanging around. I think they just, they spawn TIEs infinitely. I think I just have to wait for the Y-Wings to disable the ships. There we go. Nailed it.
Ah, like shooting Y-Wings, do you? Here's a little message from Gold Squadron.
This is Lieutenant Jason Moore of the Imperial 128th to unidentified Y-Wing. Are you quite done? My vehicle has been disabled for a good 2 minutes now.
Jason Moore, consider yourself a prisoner of the Rebel Alliance.
Well, if you quit shooting at me, I have a proposal to make. One which would serve us all.
God damn! Well, fuck Tetris. Everyone's playing try hard as fuck. Stomavet.
I'm sorry, Gavin.
Lieutenant Kaysen Moore has supplied Rogue Squadron with the location of an Imperial moon base. General Maydeen will lead the ground raid. Rogue Squadron provides air support.
I'm trying to think. Actually, we could show off another ship since this is another X-Wing level. Good old Millennium Falcon. Before then... I feel like the music is slightly different. Oh Lord, I'm getting the sweats.
Storage base nearby. It's an inventory hub for the local bases in the system. General Maydeen and his ground troops should find plenty of supplies in the base, as long as we can knock out the shield generator. It's located at the end of a canyon rift somewhere nearby.
Private channel, go ahead. Luke, how do we know Kaysen isn't beating us right into a trap? Not now, Wedge.
Yeah, cool thing about the Millennium Falcon in this game is that it automatically locks on to enemies, so you can just fucking just... Oh yeah, if you damage it, it's gonna be like, Chewie's not gonna be happy. It has a shit ton of missiles, too. Nope, I just wasted a missile. That's the only shitty thing is that, like, it's pretty big. Obviously, it's a pretty big ship, so. Alright. We're just gonna make a beeline for the shield generator. I'm probably gonna get hit by some missiles. Oh my god, frickin' shoot it! There we go.
The base shield is down. We're beginning our attack. Did Skywalker make that shot?
That was me. Now I thought I was the best. Hey! Okay, Rose, we're not done here. Let's clean up the remaining Imperials and go home.
Okay.
Make sure to destroy all Imperial air cover. We can't complete the mission unless the commandos are safe.
I would say the Millennium Falcon's really good for like missions like this.
Shooting things?
Yeah, shooting things. Or just smacking your ship right on them. That too also works.
Forces. Form up, team. Let's get back to the ship. Nice work, Kaysen.
It feels strange, though, being on the other side. I took their orders for a long time.
I, for one, am glad you're here. You're fighting for your own ideals now.
Yes. Yeah.
This level.
Kaysen Moore's information has once again provided the location of a hidden enemy base responsible for the production of Imperial walkers. Watch out for the ground scan.
Alright, so out of all the levels, I would consider this one being one of the hardest ones. Mostly because of the beginning. Because if you get caught, you automatically fail. You fail!
Kaysen Moore said this is one of many small factories where the Empire produces its ties and walkers. This is a straight hit-and-run mission. It's not gonna stop them, but it'll cripple them for a little bit. Be sure to destroy their scanning posts first. Also, a squadron of TIEs are out on a test flight, so don't waste any time. They could be back at any moment.
Alright.
Remember, take out those scanners first.
form up.
I gotta try to remember where they're all at.
We're getting a little close to those scanners.
No shit, Sherlock.
Maintain visual scanning.
There is one that kind of sneaks up on you. Yep, that's the one. Take that corner too quickly, you get caught. You can easily miss this one if you don't go this way either. Me too. I said either. I think this is the last one. Come on. Nope, nope, one more.
Good job, Rogue. They're blind.
All right, cool.
Now, take out those factories.
Yes, sir. Don't really need to take out that walker. Like I said, we're doing a hit and run. Oh boy, I'm gonna get hit. Oh, no, maybe not. Yeah! Missile missed me. Oh god, they're everywhere! And I gotta be careful, because I ain't like I got infinite lives. Normally, I'm just like, oh, I'm low on health, fuck it, I'll just crash my ship and destroy it. That's good enough. I believe it's on this side where the other factory is. Oh yeah, this is the bigger one. This is the bigger base. And shot down immediately. Matt, you killed Luke. You changed the future. You created a time paradox. So yeah, there's fighters and shit everywhere. Don't be surprised if I get killed again. Quickly, blow up. Hey, did it. Did the thing.
Good shot, Jensen. It sure is nice to take the fight to the Imperials for once. It seems like we're always playing defense. Thanks to Case, and we may just turn the tide of this war. Now let's head home. I need to paint some TIE fighters on my fuselage.
Oh, Luke. Obviously, you get gold medals if you hit, like, certain targets and stuff.
The deep canyons of Kyle 2 hide the Imperial Enclave, a sprawling facility supporting the Empire's navy throughout this sector. Destroy key elements and help break the Empire's hold on the local planets.
This mission is also pretty hard, but we will be using a Y-Wing.
Rogues, listen up. Kaysen has given us another Imperial military location. It's a large spaceport located at the end of this canyon. We're using Y-Wings because of their greater firepower, but they move like a sleepy hut, so watch it.
Technically, I could also use the Naboo Starfighter for this mission. But Where's the fun in that? I'm gonna show off all the ships.
Maintain visual scanning.
Oh, I couldn't. Okay. And you can disable stuff. Alright. A lot of times I like to use both. I feel like it does like double the damage.
Maybe slow, but they can take a beating. Didn't even scratch me.
Oh boy. Yeah. That missile launcher is like a Y-Wing's nightmare. Oh, don't shoot me, bro. Don't shoot me, bro. May have made a wrong turn. Nope, no, I didn't. I'm going the right way. Alright, let's fucking go. First, take this thing out. You dickhead. There are stormtroopers inside those things.
Array.
And you can actually destroy these in any order, but normally I just do these areas because it's closer. If we want to go all the way to the spaceport, then come all the way back here. You know, it's a waste of time. I may have to purposely kill myself just so I can like reload on bombs.
But not bad.
Oh fuck, these ties are fucking me up. Oh, there goes R2. And it blew up. Damn it, I still had bombs left. Son of a bitch. Oh well. Thankfully, the rest of Rogue Squadron helped. I don't know what this shuttle is. But you can blow it up. God, this is not working out. This is not working out. Alright, we're good. It kind of backed off. Alright, let's hurry up and get to the spaceport before I get shot down again. Okay, I cannot do these close canyons with that hood on. And of course the bonus that you guys seen like at the bottom is pretty much it upgrades the missiles and stuff, but since I've already done that, I don't have to collect them.
Fight him!
I tried to destroy it. Didn't work out too well. Alright, now this is a pretty big area, so... I also have to take out these. I'm trying not to get shot down, Matt. Ooh, almost got shot. No. Okay. So it was the turn secluded.
Main computer offline. Targeting computer offline. Ah, just off Rogue 7. Get out of their way. Hobby, what happened?
Wedge made it, but he's gonna be captured for sure. I'm under a lot of fire.
Increase speed, full throttle. Hold on, Wedge. Okay, Rose, we're not done here. Let's clean up the remaining Imperials and go home.
Hey, did it.
Rogue Squadron, this is General Rikus. Excellent work. The sensor array and spaceport facilities on Kyle 2 are now inoperable. Imperial activities are sure to slow down in this sector.
I'll never get a silver in this mission. At all. Oh wow, I would have. I would have got a silver if my accuracy wouldn't shit. What can you do?
You must find Wedge before the Imperials deliver him to the prison facilities and certain death.
So, you can, in fact, play the Nebu Starfighter in this mission because it's technically an X-Wing mission. But these X-Wing have ion cannons. So, I wouldn't recommend it. We gotta rescue Wedge, man. He's our boy.
It's a mining colony, but the Imperials often keep political prisoners here, too. There should be an armored hover train nearby, transporting captured rebels to a central station before moving on to the prison. I'm sure Wedge is with them.
Luke, I'm reading a small convoy at Mark 4-9. I'm also scanning a lot of human life readings. It could be the prisoners.
That's not them. Follow the hover train.
What's it going to be, Commander?
Dun dun dun.
Rocket foils in attack position.
What's gravity fighters?
Jesus! Knock me into another frickin' X-Wing.
Use your ion cannons. We want to disable the train, not destroy it.
Yeah, it does not.
Wedge is definitely on that train.
I'm hit! Thanks, R2. The train is slowing down. Looks like this is working.
If you happen to not disable the train, and it's like close to the prison, he'll literally be like, this isn't gonna work. I'm like, dude, like, relax. But you can get this mission done pretty fairly quickly.
Help me out here.
That was close.
Rogue Squadron, this is General Rikus. Excellent work.
Now you can get that mission done fairly quickly.
R2 says the train is completely shut down. Bring Wedge's X-Wing in.
Nice job, Skywalker. I'm beginning to see why they say you're the best.
Now, I thought I was the best.
Wedge! Good to hear from you, Antilles. How was the hover train?
Food was good, but the service was lousy.
Oh, Wedge. I actually want to see how quickly that was. A minute and 11 seconds. Nothing.
Now that Wedge is safe, help General Madine free other rebels from the notorious prisons of Kessel. I'm
trying to think. I just want to see what the next mission would be. Oh, fuck.
Now that Wedge is safe, help
Alright, we're gonna go in for a risk here. Yeah.
This is a flight of Y-wings captured.
We're going with the TIE Interceptor, baby. Let's go. Keep in mind, it does not have anything special. It's just a TIE fighter.
Listen, while I was on that train, I found out there are other rebels at the main prison facility. Chris Nadine and his commanders will follow us in and get them out.
Any idea what we're up against?
Unknown.
But TIE fighters are pretty fast.
Switching power to front deflector screens.
Oh, yeah, I should probably go with them.
They Maintain visual scanning.
What's the enemy fighter?
We're receiving the data from your R2. Rebels located. We're on our way.
I've got a problem here. Whoa.
Brothers, I'm here to fight with you.
We have some sort of energy field we can't get through. My guess is that they have some sort of generator nearby. Do you think you can help us out?
You got it.
Stopping by here anyway, so I might as well take out what I can. Oof, almost freaking ran into that. There we go. Let's head back.
Back, got it. Shields
down. Commencing
rescue. Rogue Squadron, where's our cover?
I'm covering.
We can't take these ties.
Especially for this mission, it's kind of hard. It's just kind of a risk.
I'm clear.
Alright. You say you're clear, but... don't think any more ties show up. See, that respawns like one at a time. Let me take out the rest of these guys.
Rescue complete!
Hey, don't shoot at me, bro. Boys. Oh, it might be wise to take that out. Probably one or two ties are gonna spawn out of nowhere. Oh, there they are. Oh, jeez. We'll suicide into it. The ties are pretty strong. Oh, AT. AT-ST. That's the only thing that sucks is that, like, trying to take these out is a little bit harder with the TIE fighter. I don't have any missiles.
We're on our way.
No, don't do that. Don't. I think I'll TIE fighter. Oh, shit. Hello. Get out of here, Hope. Yeah, I'll get a next turn around. Hang on. TIE fighters are pretty sensitive. You can stub your toe and a TIE fighter will blow up. As I stated, stub your toe and a TIE fighter will blow up. I gotta hurry up and get back to that prison.
forgot these guys are a little harder to hit. Once you get close, they're pretty good. They're not quite clear yet. Oh. Like, look at that! Like, what the fuck? Some goddamn skilled pilots. One more to go. Hello? Rescue complete. What the hell is this goddamn TIE fighter? It's like, ooh, on top of me, or is he following me? He's on top of me. Well, guess what? Now you're dead. How does that make you feel? Oh, whoops. Wrong way. That's either all of them or there's one more prison. There is one more prison.
Last group scan. Here we come.
Coop. One paying attention to me. Thankfully. What? Ah, damn. Oh, I scratched one. Hey. Oh, no. One more. And Luke's dead. But guess what? They're clear. I got these stormtroopers and such. Oh yeah. Inside of a TIE fighter, looks like. Didn't really show off, You guys have been in the Millennium Falcon in the movies. It looks exactly like that. Once I played this mission, and I crashed into the ship because it took too much damage and it just blew up. I was very disappointed. Mission complete. GG.
Good work, Rote. General Nadine, we'll buy your boys around when we get back to the fleet.
You're on, Commander Skywalker. Good luck.
In the skies above Talaran, fight the Empire for control of the Tabana gas platforms. But be careful not to harm the civilian operations there.
Now, I would do the A-Wing, but Let's do Nebu Starfighter. I've already kind of showed off the A-Wing enough, and it's not my favorite ship. If I had the choice, I'd rather do the Naboo Starfighter. It's maybe the last A-Wing mission, too. I'm gonna get some water real quick and enjoy the Star Wars music.
Unfortunately, the Imperials own it. They harvest the Tabana gas to use in their weapons. It increases their firepower. They process and store it on these floating platforms.
There are civilians down there too, so make sure what you're shooting at is Imperial. We're here to take out their Tabana gas supplies and do whatever damage we can to the local TIE fighter squadron.
Huh. Now I know what it's like to be on the other side of one of these little raids.
I feel like a lot of audio is repeated too in this game.
I'm having trouble with my scanner.
It's the Tabana gas. Calibrate 7 Mach 9.
Good shooting. Maintain visual scanning.
What kind of fighter?
Cool.
Excellent work.
And each platform gets harder and harder. I mean, that's one way to do it. I mean, blowing it up is optional. You know, with your own ship.
Good job.
I don't know why, but a lot of times in this mission is a little bit glitchy. Because, like, the ones, like, on the flat platform, you can just shoot down on it and it won't blow up. Of course, you could change shooting modes like rapid fire, then, you know. Duels. Bloop. Yeah, see? You guys saw me shoot that twice. And I still didn't get through. I want to use a missile to accidentally blow up at one by mistake.
Nice job, Skywalker. I'm beginning to see why they say you're the best.
I'm beginning to notice repeated lines in this game. Oh yeah, this one just go ham. Ugh. Hit and run, hit and run, hit and run, hit and run. Ugh. Okay, don't blow yourself up trying to do it.
Thank you.
work.
There's a lot of Imperial activity up here.
No shit. Alright. Okay, it's not this part. Oh, maybe blue one. Okay, never mind.
The blue ones are civilians. Let's check our fire. I'm hit!
That was a blue one. Oops. Yeah, if you blow up too many blue ones, the mission will fail. And you don't want that. I might blow up here. Is there one left? Oh, I may have missed one on the other platform. Yep, I did.
Excellent work.
Alright, so I may crash here. This is the part I'm thinking of. It's just a nice view from, seeing it from your cockpit. Oh boy, look at all those fighters. Thankfully, I wasn't in front of it. Alright, anyway. Hey, this is where Luke hang from in episode 5.
My squadron scouted it once for a possible Imperial takeover. Too small, though.
But not there. Damn it. I was kind of steering towards this that way, like at least if I crash it'll succeed the mission, but nah, didn't look out there.
Good job.
Fuck you. I forgot those are missile ones.
Well, I can tell you one thing, Luke. The officer on duty is not going to enjoy explaining this damage to the local moth.
He may not live to tell about it. Moth Theoden is notoriously unforgiving.
Moss Sirenin is like the bad guy in this game. Wow, almost got silver again. Accuracy is poop. Oh god, this mission.
During the Talaran operation, a team of rebel commandos stole several AT-PTs from an Imperial base on Fest. Unfortunately, their escape did not proceed as well as they expected.
Again, this is a hard mission. And I don't remember that much about it, because it's like one of the least played missions I have. After I got that silver, I was like, okay, I'm done. I'm good. Thank you for playing. Next mission.
When you reach your destination, you'll find an Imperial research facility from which a team of rebel commandos are attempting to liberate a squad of AT-PTs. Their escape has become compromised, and we need your help to get them out of there. The speeders and tow cables will help you with any walkers you may find. Good luck.
Rogue Squadron, report in.
Rogue 7 standing by.
All right.
Rogue 8 standing by. Rogue 9 standing by.
Rogue 10 standing by.
Maintain visual scanning. There they are. Looks like we'll need to clear a path for them. Rogue 8 and 9, concentrate your firepower on that gate. Everyone else is with me. We're going after the walker. Activate harpoon.
Quicker you take out the walker, the easier it would be, because the walker's kind of like the only thing that's like a serious threat.
Then you are in restricted airspace. Surrender immediately.
Nah.
Cable out. Let her go.
Moff's here.
Thank you.
Now, so I'm going to take out this walker while I'm at it. I think I might be able to buy a little time by taking it out and getting back over there in time. One less walker I have to deal with as they, Oh, fuck. Alright, here we go. Saved it. Woof! I almost ruined that. Alright, let me catch back up to him.
The gate is down. Repeat, the gate is down. Got it. Let's make sure they get to the landing zone intact.
Quickly, quickly, quickly!
One more pass.
Alright, cool. It's just those little tanks.
Good job.
So you can destroy that if you want to, but I think that just gets you that bonus. Oh, that's right, I forgot. There you go, this way. I might get shot down soon. I don't want to get shot down. Ugh! Come on. Oh my god, do I only have one left?
Fighters at 2-7. I got it.
I may only have one left. Oh, fuck bombers, god damn it. This is stressful. Alright, cool. These guys.
Watch for enemy fighter. I'm on it.
Fuck, I only got one ATPT left. Fuck me. Guess the other two got bombed when I was somewhere else. They're just gonna infinitely spawn. Am I in the clear, hopefully? Might be good.
Excellent work.
Cool.
The ATPTs have reached the landing zone. Repeat. The ATPTs have reached.
Or the ATPT. You might want to get rid of that S. I think the other two blew up.
Excellent work, Rogue Squadron. Those AKPTs would have been used by Moss Tiridan, the local Imperial Governor. We believe he's consolidating his forces for an attack on our Bacta supplies.
But without Bacta, our medical supplies are useless.
I know, Wedge. We're watching him closely. Good work. Now head back to base.
Thank you.
Moss Sirdan has chosen to hold Chandrila hostage in an attempt to make the rebellion pay for its raid on Fest. You must help the innocent people of Chandrila protect the supply train and stop the Empire.
Alright. So. The brand new ship that is known as the V-Wing. There's only one mission with that ship. But I particularly like using this with, this mission.
This is a new craft. Fast, light, and unpredictable.
It's a really fun mission to use with the V-Wing.
Rogue Squadron, this is General Riken. Chandrila is under attack. Imperial forces are attempting to bombard and surround the city with wall builders. You must protect the hover train. The supplies it is carrying must reach Chandrila, or we will lose the city.
Someone getting beat up upstairs? All I hear is... And B-Wing has seeker missiles. And another cool thing is that it has rapid fire. That's the only downside to it is that the cannons burn out.
What's for enemy fighters?
It kind of sucks that if I put in infinite continues, I'd be it's pretty much god. It'd be god tier with this ship. Cause you know you only have six seeker missiles.
Inbound fighters at 10:13. I copy.
I've got a problem here. Bomb
hit.
Nope. Noop. Get out of here. Oh, thanks, guys. Ah, damn it. I meant for those missiles to take out the other two, but no worries. No worries at all. Oh, hello. Every Star Wars game has good music. Yeah, the rapid fire mode's super good. And has boosters! I feel like the V-Wing doesn't really get a lot of love in this game.
This is Mark Sheridan. Your resistance is useless. As you can see, I have blockaded the city, and Chandrila is now mine. You will surrender, or I will shoot you all down.
Enemy fighters at Mark 2.
I'm on it.
That's why this V-Wing is so good. Look at it, three fighters all at once.
Protect the evacuation shuttle.
Hold on, my blasters are still cooling.
I just gotta wait for these to fly away. Did I save the whole train or did I lose one? I may have lost a train car.
There we go. Go lift it off. Oh, missed one. There we go. Actually, let me make sure. I don't remember if any more spawn here or not. Nope, they're good.
We have TIE bombers and TIE interceptors on scanner.
This would be really easier, but meh. I still got rapid fire mode. I will say this mission is, you know, after you there we go. Oh, fuck! Shit! God, the TIE interceptors don't fucking play in this one. I mean, if I go down, that's fine. No worries. Oh, there we go. Okay, that works. Guess I just had to take out the bombers.
Luke, I've lost my stabilizer.
Have your ARC unit lock it down, Kaysen. Take them all? Ah, of course.
Moth Theoden.
How pathetic. Allying yourself with those rebel criminals, Rogue Squadron. You and your so-called rogues helped in the absconding of my ATTTs and the plundering of my research facility. My retaliation shall be swift and just.
There is nothing just about your actions.
Do you no longer harbor any loyalty to our Emperor? Defecting to the rebel terrorist shall be your undoing, Kaysen. Unfortunate to lose such a fine officer, but the weak will die off to make room for the strong. It is the way of the universe. Farewell, little rodent.
There you are, you coward. Do you think you can get away in that shuttle?
Kaysen, do not pursue that ship. Repeat, do not pursue Cyrodiil. We don't know how many ships he has backing him up. We must remain here to secure Chandrilla.
I copy.
Coward.
Yeah, Moss Sirin's a dickhead. Oh god, this one.
Kaysen Moore is engineering an assault on a volcano base at Sullust in retaliation for the blockade on Chandrilla.
Alright, so this one's going to be a Nebu Starfighter because I don't want to get a game over. I mean, you can beat this with the Y-Wing, but like when it comes down to speed and just trying to get this, you know, not trying to get shot down, Nebu Starfighter is kind of the way to go. Because just like literally everything is shooting at you.
Alright, here's our chance to hit them back for Chandrilla. Kaysen, did General Riken brief you?
Yes, the location of this Imperial base was supplied to us by Bossen spies. It's a crucial link to the rest of the solar system, so it's also well protected, hidden inside this volcano. They use the volcanic activity to power a geothermal generator which is regulated by a shielded central capacitor. But inside the volcano, several transmitters are feeding thermal energy to the capacitor. Destroy the transmitters.
And we take the shield down. Kaysen, you lead the way.
Alrighty. Let's go! Alright.
Okay, that's one. You know what to look for. That's it, but not bad.
Hit and run, baby, hit and run. Ah, damn it, didn't blow up. Yeah, so imagine flying around in a fucking Y-Wing with all this going on. Oh fuck, I'm gonna get shot down. Oh boy. Ah. Mostly those fucking missile turrets that really screw you over.
Oh,
And this is what the bonus looks like.
Sir, we found some seeker proton torpedoes.
Oh, shit. I didn't realize that was one. No worries. We'll just turn around and head back. Last time I playtested this game, it kind of crashed on this mission, so I kind of hope it doesn't actually do that again. Matt, follow the radar. There you go. Ugh! Maybe the last one, actually. Yep, it is. Cool.
The shield should be down.
Let's all rendezvous back at the capacitor. We'll need to hit it with all our firepower.
Watch for enemy fighters.
They gain visual scanning.
Yeah, and this is the kind of the downside to having the Y-Wing in this mission, because takes a few hits. Yeah, see? Ugh! Oh, cool. Good job, Rogues. GG.
Let's get out of here before the volcano destabilizes.
Rogue Squadron, I'm afraid you'll have to cut your celebration short. Moff Dearden has begun his attack on Cyphera.
He used us. This is all a diversion.
Dude, he's attacking Cyphera. Oh, wow. Almost got it. Almost.
By leading Rogue Squadron to Sullust, Moff Dearden has secretly captured the Bacta supplies of Cyphera and now intends to cut off medical supplies to the Alliance. Free Cyphera and defeat Dearden once and for all.
Alright, so we are going to go with the X-Wing here. Normally I would do the Y-Wing, but I'm like, why not?
Cyphera. Be careful, team. We've got to hit Imperial targets only. Avoid civilian casualties at all costs. We can't afford to lose those back to containers, so be careful. Pick your targets and go.
Alright. That's not a good way to start.
Maintain visual scanning.
Watch out for those Bacta containers.
I'm trying. They won't let me. Oh, I was about to say, what the hell am I missing? Ah, damn it. Damn fucking... Oh, lost R2. That sucks. I thought he was gonna get shot down, but never mind. Take care of those bombers. Because they're nothing but a pain in the ass. Damn it. Thought that was cool. Oh, God. Oh, please, don't blow up. Ah! Right here, at least let me use all my missiles first. before you shoot me down. I forgot, there's like one TIE fighter that actually follows you around and tries to shoot you down. Yeah, this fighter goes out of your... the fighter goes out of his way to shoot you down. Fuck, I only got one more ship, don't I? Oof. Yeah, I think if too many of them get blown up, then you fail. Oh, accidentally killed somebody. Oh, someone got shot down. Fuck me. Alright, worst case scenario, I'll just play as the V-Wing. Ugh! Go. Oh, for fuck's sakes, blow up, please. Jesus. I might get shot down here.
Down.
Oh, there goes R2, so my shield's gonna stay the way it is. Like, see what I'm saying? And then... then just automatically just shoot you down. Or not shoot you down, but... Oh yeah, it takes you like all the way to back to the damn main menu. But no worries, we'll just do it with the V-Wing. It's quicker and easier. Whoops.
The Incom T-65 X-Wing is the fighter that killed the Death Star. Almost perfect balance of speed, maneuverability, and defensive shield.
Alright. Now watch how quickly this will be done.
Take your targets and go. Rapid fire mode engaged. Maintain visual scanning. Burnout on cannon 1. Burnout on cannon 2. Hold on, my blasters are still cooling.
Oh fuck, is that thing still up? Oh no, but someone else is up! Shit! Alright, no worries. You fucking fighter, get out of here. Okay, where did that missile shot come from? How are you shooting over the hill? You dick.
Burn out my cannon 1. Burn out on cannon 2. Hold on, my blasters are still cooling. Put your shields down.
bombers.
Take your booster.
Like, that fighter is like right on my ass. I'd prefer not to get shot down again. Boy, TIE Fighter's back. No. All right, cool. I'm pretty sure I'll get shot down again, especially when especially when Malsirna shows up, because, you know, he's... Oh, fuck me. No! Alright. Wow, and it survived. That's kind of funny. Oh, that was the last one.
So you're the young man who destroyed the Death Star.
Oh, fuck me. Yeah, so all those missiles are just circling around trying to hit them.
You're a very talented pilot. You have learned much, Skywalker. I'm hit.
Okay, let's not try to die here. Because I am, like, on my last ship. Hello? I heard a missile launch. Fuck me. Please don't get shot down. Oh my god. I mean, no one said that this mission would be easy. Fuck. Why keep going the other way? Alright, let's try that again.
Pick your targets and go. Rapid fire mode engaged. Burnout on cannon 1. Burnout on cannon 2.
Whoops, I wasted one.
Watch out for those factor containers.
Hold on, my blasters are still cooling.
I'm Damn it. Come on. There we go. Damn, I thought I was gonna try to last long enough, but old wheel. Nice. So this will be a little easier now. Got through that a lot quicker.
Hold on, my blasters are still cooling. Ah, you're a very talented pilot. You have learned much, Skywalker. Too bad you didn't join the Empire. I could have used a pilot with your skills.
I feel like that shuttle is very small. Ugh. At least I got my missiles back. I think he is almost dead. There we go. Just shoot all my missiles out. He dead.
Woohoo! Great job, Rogue Squadron! The Imperials won't get my Fira now.
Hey!
Hey, where are you?
Down on the ground, still waiting for someone to pick me up.
I'm on my way, Kaysen.
So this next mission is pretty interesting.
The World Devastators are raining destruction on the peaceful world of Mon Calamari. Fly as Wedge Antilles and battle against all odds to stop their evil conquest.
So this was based on a, I forgot what it was, but I know a book was made for it. Pretty much this takes, like, I forgot what specific time, but it's, like, way after Luke, like, leaves Rogue Squadron and, you know, he does his own thing and Wedge takes over as the commander. But, like, supposedly, like, the Emperor comes back as a clone and he secretly constructed the World Devastators. Or this might actually explain it right here. Save me the time. I'm trying to remember. Remember. And it does explain. Cool. Yes, after that. It's not a mysterious leader, it's the Emperor. He cloned himself a lot. And damn, these, but supposedly, they're a lot bigger than what's portrayed in the game, because I believe, like, I forgot who, like, runs, like, who decides if something's canon or not, but they decided that these World Devastators are miniature versions of the actual World Devastators. So, yeah. Look at all those V-Wings.
This is Commander Wedge Antilles of Rogue Squadron. We are coming to your assistance.
Look at those Devastators, man. They're big boys.
Sir, the Devastators are getting close to the city. Rapid fire mode engaged.
Yeah, this is the only mission where you actually play as Wedge instead of Luke.
Hit your booster. Booster's recharging.
Alright, and you have to attack the little shield thing right on top of here.
This is Rogue 3. Sir, my R2 has found a weak spot. It's a shield generator on top. If we destroy it, we have a better chance of taking these things down.
Burnout on Cannon 1. Burnout on Cannon 2.
Oh, God, you... Oh man, I forgot how fucking powerful these things are. But yeah, don't get caught up in there because you will get sucked into that vacuum. It's no bueno.
Let's take out the leg jet. If we destroy the leg, the Devastator has no propulsion.
Hit your boosters.
Oh, really?
Burnout on Cannon 1. Burnout on Cannon 2. Hold on, my last is still cooling.
Cool.
Whoa, that got him.
And it just destroys all the guns on here. These TIE fighters are a lot faster and more, trying to think of a word here. They're stronger. Because from what I remember, from what I've looked up, especially about the World Devastators, is that these are droid-operated TIE fighters. So they're kind of like the... Damn, what'd you call them? The droid fighters from the prequels. Oh, fuck me. Come on, dude. Fuck it. I'm not trying to follow him around all damn day.
Booster's recharging.
Alright, since I'm most likely gonna get shot down. Hopefully, I took out any of the missile launchers. God damn it.
Weapons malfunction.
I ain't trying to get sucked up.
More fighters inbound on 17.28.
Oh god. Oh, fuck it. Alright, well I was gonna try to crash, but it looks like that didn't work, so I'll just try to take them on.
Rapid fire mode.
Oh, it's my own guys. They won't fucking stop it. All they're doing is following me. Alright, no worries.
Commander,
again.
There we go. I believe there's one more Devastator. I'll try to save at least maybe one or two of my missiles. All the world devastators do is just suck up, you know.
Great job, Minot. We stopped the devastator. Now let's take out those TIEs.
Calamari isn't safe until those TIE fighters are destroyed.
Damn it. Oh, more spawned. RIP. Damn it. Wait, please stop running into me. Please? Sakes. These goddamn things are so agile.
Get me out here.
Alright, if I have to fucking knock myself into one, I got enough health for one more. There we go. Yay, did it.
They're gone. We've completely routed the world devastators. We've taken a lot of damage, Rogues. But I want you to know, we saved another world from the Empire. We did well here today. Let's go home.
So that is the end of the main game, but there are three bonus levels that if you put in the cheat code DEADDAC, you can access them. This is particularly not my favorite one, though.
Race through Beggar's Canyon in your T-16 Skyhopper. Test your skill against Zeb, Dac, or Wedge.
This is at Beggar's Canyon. It's tricky, so listen up. The main canyon is fairly simple, but watch out for Sandclaws taking a shortcut. The left branch is harder, but the right branch is the toughest. Lots of twists and turns. Mace and I used to shoot through it with no brakes.
Well, I'm an old Bantha, so I'd better take the main route. I'll meet you at the moisture farm on the plateau.
Well, I'll take the left branch if you don't mind racing against me. Guess you're on the right branch, huh, Wedge? You got it.
And it's a race. It's a race. If you get out of the canyon, mission failed. If you shoot one of them down, it's a mission fail. If you blew up, if you blow up, it's a mission fail. So yeah, I'd say it's one of the most unfair missions.
Skywalker, what are you doing?
That could also happen, is that they run into you. They run into you and blow you up. Yeah.
We're gonna have to start.
Whoa! You lost! Commander, you must be getting rusty.
Yeah, it was gonna... Yeah, as soon as you leave, they're like, oh, I think you're cheating. And then, yeah, the mission just ends. Like I said, it's not the most fairest mission. The fact that I even got a gold on it was shocking. I'm gonna try going the left way. Because I think that's the easiest. I don't remember, but... I'm not the best pilot in the world. Yeah, I think this is the one right here. See, look at it. You're gonna frickin' knock into me. That's another thing, is that if their ship hits you, you'll be, like, knocked into the air. There we go.
I feel guilty beating you guys. I used to make this run every day in my old T-16.
And that's the mission. I think that route you get a bronze, I believe. This one is one of my favorites.
Travel down the Death Star trench, eliminating as many laser cannons as possible. If the trench guns stop firing, you can bet the Death Star's complement of TIEs will be in close pursuit. Continue down the trench until you reach the exhaust port area. Good luck, and may the Force be with you.
So you can do this as the X-Wing or the Naboo Starfighter, but we're going to create a little bit of a time paradox. Naboo Starfighter. Plus, it's a hell of a lot faster than the X-Wings are.
Cut the chatter. Wedge, hold them off as best you can. Rogue, we're gonna have company real soon.
So, inbound fighter to 1013. It's what you think it is. It's the Death Star Trench Run.
Help me out here.
And I managed to get a gold with in this level because I used the Naboo Starfighter, because it saved me a ton of time.
Fighters inbound on 17.28. Help me out, yeah. I'm hit. Rear shields down. We just lost Rogue 9. I'm hit. Rear shields down. Ah! I'm clear, but my fighter is down.
Yeah, you don't necessarily have to, like, even lock on. Just tap the left C button twice, and it'll just... Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
I'm sure the stabilizer's broken loose again. See if you can't lock it down. Ah! I'm clear, but my fighter is down. I'm hit. Yee-haw! Han, Chewie, well, what are you doing here?
Rumpf.
Thanks, Han. And good luck. I'm clear, but my fighter is down.
Ooh. Oh. I think it's also a... I think it's also a mission failure if you pull out of the Death Star. Oh, here we go. And mission successful. There's no ending cutscene to it, so it's just like you shoot that and boom. Oh, not gold, excuse me, silver. I don't know why I thought I had a gold. See, look at it. Wow, actually, I almost got it. Then we have the very last mission. Battle of Hoth.
Experience the Battle of Hoth from the cockpit of your snowspeeder as you hold off Imperial forces and help the Rebel transports escape.
So I thought that was kind of cool that they included Battle of Hoth and the Death Star Trench Run. Nice little cool bonus missions.
The transports can't escape unless the probe droids are gone.
But of course, we're not exactly... Well, we're towards the end, but there's actually one more mission but you have to enter a passcode in order to get to it.
Rogue 10 is down in Sector Lambda. He needs your assistance.
I copy. I'm on it.
Kind of shocked. He's dodging that laser fire like it's fucking nothing. Did I hit something? I guess I did. Bleh. Look at that.
Go for the lift.
So yeah, we got three walkers to deal with.
Here we go, Dak.
Yeah, Dak. He doesn't talk though. No reinforcements coming from this way. Alright, so we're gonna take care of this guy first. Pass, baby. And got it. Two more to go.
Another victory for Rogue Squadron. Don't get cocky.
Now, this is a little hard because you're going to be doing in between walkers. I think that's kind of what the challenge for this is. But of course, when you use the harpoon, it kind of slows down the walker a little bit. Thankfully, the other walker wasn't in my field of vision, or else this would have been a problem. No, don't do that. Alright, cool. Someone's getting fucked.
One more pass.
Damn. We did it.
The base has been evacuated. We'll meet you at the rendezvous point. And Luke, the Falcon made it out all right. Don't do anything foolish like running off to Dagobah.
It's funny because he does. But for the main game, that's Rogue Squadron. You just have one more mission left. You gotta enter a passcode for it. Yes, I think it's chicken. You get a special little bonus mission where you get to play as an AT-ST. You got like little areas that you can shoot at. Z button kind of helps you do kind of like an aiming upward type of thing. Usually it auto aims pretty well. Hold the Z button while you're walking. I don't know if I'm hitting it or not. Because, yes, you can fail this mission. Absolutely. And if you fail, you have to, reset the I don't know if you have to reset or not the console, but oh my god, get closer. I don't want to get get too close and get fucking wrecked. Because I think this thing can only take like two hits. Am I like really missing it? There we go. Oh, come on. We were just hitting it. Come on. There we go. This is where the fun begins. If you just hold down the Z button, you'll just auto walk. You don't have to worry about messing with the control stick. There you go. That shuttle does not blow up, so I'm not gonna... I hate it when he does that. Another episode 2 quote, yeah, man. Look, it's mini Mos Eisley, question mark? Settlement over there. Doubt I'll be able to shoot from this far. There we go. I was about to say, come on. Come on, baby. That one guy is running around like, holy fuck, an AT-ST, shit! Blown up. And then mission complete. You destroyed everything. And that's Star Wars Rogue Squadron. Of course, obviously, I'll be playing the second one, and then I'm gonna put some money aside so I can get the third one, because the third one is also on GameCube. Or the, yeah, 2 and 3 are on GameCube. 2 is super fun, so I can't wait to play that. Oh god, no, the demo has started. No, we've seen that already. Stop it. There's some other passcodes and stuff that you can put in for it. Yes, showroom. I believe the showroom just plays, like, music. Oh yeah, you can see all the cutscenes, concert hall, which has, like, all the music in the game. And as it's playing the music and stuff, you look at the different vehicles and stuff that are in the game. Which is pretty cool. I'm not sure if you have to put in a cheat code for that, though. You may have to. I don't remember. You get biographies on each of the people in the game.
Wedge Antilles, born on Corellia, had a hard life growing up. His parents were freighter pilots, killed trying to save a space station when Wedge was young. He's got a natural ability to lead, and I wouldn't be surprised if someday Wedge became a rogue leader, but he'd much rather be flying missions than attending parades. An excellent pilot, Wedge saved my life at the Death Star, and I owe him. I expect to see Wedge do great things for the Rebellion. Dak is one of the newer, younger pilots, and I don't know him as well. He replaced Biggs after the Battle of Yavin, and is showing promise as an X-Wing pilot. He's still new, though, but what he lacks in experience, he makes up in enthusiasm. He sort of reminds me of myself back when all I wanted was a little excitement and a chance to take on the Empire.
Buddy dies. Spoilers.
Hobby is the skeptic of Rogue Group. He doesn't warm up quickly to new ideas, but he never challenges the authority of his superiors. Hobby just does most of his thinking on the inside. You never hear from him unless he has something absolutely crucial to say. He originally trained at the Imperial Academy with Biggs and Porkins, and he jumped ship at the same time they did too. Since then, he's been working in the Solus system, running guns, but now he's been chosen to fly with Rogue Squadron. Zev is a little older than the rest of us. He's probably got a few stories to tell, but he keeps pretty quiet. He joined up some time ago after the Empire killed his parents for secretly supplying the rebellion. Since then, he's been a great asset, once holding off three TIE fighters while an Alliance transport fled into hyperspace. I've only seen Jansen truly happy when he was manning the guns of a Y-Wing or Snowspeeder. He's a gunner, first and foremost. Wedge swears by his accuracy and knack for hitting small moving targets, like TIE fighters. Jansen always has a short temper, though. Many is the time we've had to pull him out of a cantina fight, but I would trust him with my life. Kaysen was born on Alderaan and joined the Academy at a pretty young age. She flew TIE Interceptors for the Empire, and eventually they gave her the 128th TIE Interceptor Squadron. She was loyal to the Emperor, but when the Death Star destroyed Alderaan, her feelings began to change. When we met up on Gerard 5, she decided to defect and join the Rebel Alliance. Good thing, Kaysen is an ace pilot, definitely one of our best. I think she and Wedge are secretly in competition for the top slot, but I wouldn't want to bet on that race.
But, Kaysen Moore is actually not a canon pilot. She was just here for the game. And I think Elite Rogues, I think that just shows like top scores and stuff. Yeah, it does. But yeah, that's besides the settings and stuff, that's Star Wars Rogue Squadron.